Hello all. So in the last class, we had discussed about what is the state and what is state variable. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss more about state space model for linear systems. Okay. So how do you define state? State is the minimum number of variables that is necessary to determine the complete dynamic behavior of the system given the input. Okay, or in other words, the minimum number of initial conditions that you need to determine the complete behavior, okay, once the input is given. That is what we mean by state variable. Okay, so we had seen how to define state variables. Let us now see the state variable represent model for linear systems. State variable model for linear systems. State space model for linear systems. Okay, so we will start with an example. Fine. Suppose this is the question. You are given a differential equation. You need to obtain the state space model. Obtain the state space model. Obtain the state space model for an LTI system. For an LTI. What is LTI? Linear time invariant. Okay, for an LTI system, described by y double dot t plus 6 y dot t plus 8 y of t equals r of t. Okay, in the last class we had seen how to define each differentiated variable can be chosen as a state variable. Okay, so here which is the differentiated variable y, right? So let the first state variable. Okay, so state variables are normally indicated by x1, x2, etc. Okay, so I call let x1 of t or let y of t equals x1 of t, right? So what will be y dot t from this? Y dot t will be x1 dot t. Okay, that means I will call that as another state variable, x2. Okay, then what will be y double dot in that case? It will be nothing but x2 dot. Y double dot will be x2. Okay, so how can I rewrite this equation? Y double dot will be equal to what? Which implies y double dot equals what? R of t minus 6 y dot t minus 8 y of t. Okay, that means R of t minus, what is y dot? Y dot is nothing but x2. So minus 6 x2 minus 8. What was y of t? X1 of t. So I can write this as x1 of t. And y double dot is nothing but x2 dot t. So this is x2 dot t. Okay, so this can be arranged in a matrix form. Okay, so let's say this is x1 dot, x2 dot equal to what? Some matrix into its respective state variables x1t, x2t, plus some other thing into r of t. Okay, r of t was the input here. Fine, r of t was the input here. Okay, so what is x1 dot t? X1 dot t is x2, that means 0, 1, 0. 0 into x1 plus 1 into x2 plus 0 into r. So x1 dot equal to x2. What is x2 dot? It is minus 8x1, minus 6x2, and plus r of t. Okay, so I can write this as my state variable representation. And what is the output here? Y is the output variable, right? So y of t will be what? Nothing but x1 of t. So I can write my y of t as what? X1, x2, plus 0 into r. Okay, so in this way, for an LTI system, we can represent the state equation in matrix form. Okay, so you see, we have converted a second order equation into two first order equations. That's the basic idea. Okay, so if you have an nth order differential equations, they can be replaced by n first order differential equations. Okay, that's the basic idea. Okay, so otherwise, what would I have done? You would have taken transfer function. When you take that, if you had taken the transfer function, what it would have been? Y of s by r of s would have been what? Would have been 1 divided by square plus 6s plus 8 in the normal way, normal case. Okay, but here it gives an idea about the internal structure also. That's the advantage over transfer function approach. Done? Okay. So you can see here that this is some kind of matrix. Let me call this vector as x dot. Okay, what's the meaning of this bar under the x? It means that x dot is a vector, column vector. It's a vector. Okay, then this is a 2x2 matrix. Okay, so I will call this as A. And this is again x plus another column, another array B and U. Okay, where U is the input signal. Okay, the general notation is U of T. And here this is C. I can write this as X. This is a D and this is U. In a general framework, I am speaking of. Okay, so this representation is called the state space model. Okay, so X dot equals AX plus BU, Y equals CX plus D. This is called the state space form of representation or state space modeling. Okay, so we will generalize that. So here I took a simple example just to make the things simple, just to clarify the things. Okay, so in general case, for an nth order system, with P inputs, and Q outputs, okay, the state equation matrix form is, the state equations in matrix form is, okay, so you see there are, it's an nth order system. So I told you an nth order differential equation can be converted into n number of first order equations. Okay, so how many states will be there? There will be n number of states, x1, x2, etc. up to xn. Okay, so on the left hand side, you should have the first order derivative of the state variable. So I will write this as x1 dot, x2 dot, blah, 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 xn dot t. Okay, equal to what? Some matrix. Okay, suppose the A11, A12, etc. are the coefficients. Okay, so I can write this as A11, A12. How many up to what? Up to A1n, because there are n number of state variables. Okay, A1, because you see, after this thing, we need to have the state variables x1t, x2t, blah, 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 xnt. Okay, so it should be compatible for multiplication, right? So okay, so what's the order of this column vector? It is an n cross one. There will be n rows and one column. So what should be the order of this thing? What's the order of this? It should be n cross one. So naturally, the number of columns must be n. So how many rows must be there? There should be n number of rows. So that means it should be a square matrix. Okay, this should be an n by n, an n cross n matrix like this. Okay, so then second row, A21, A22, etc. up to A2n, right? So it goes on like this. Last row, AN1, AN2, etc. ANN. Okay, plus something into U. Okay. So how many inputs are there? There are P number of inputs. So that means U1, U2, etc. up to UP. Okay, because there are P number of inputs. So let the coefficients associated be B11, etc. Okay, so up to what point I should go? B11, B12, etc. up to what? B1P. Okay, then only it will be compatible for multiplication. Okay, B11 into U1 plus B12 into U2 plus etc. plus B1P into U. Similarly, the next row, B21, B22, etc. up to B2. So it goes on like this. What will be the last row? The last row will be BN1, BN2, etc. up to BNP. Okay, so it is more or less similar to what we obtained here. Fine. More or less similar to what we obtained here. Right? Here, what is the order of the differential equation? Second order. So we have two state vectors, x1, x2. So on the left side, we have x1 dot, x2 dot. Okay, so since there are two state vectors, your A matrix would be of the order 2 by 2, 2 cross 2, 2 rows and 2 columns. Okay, and why this is a thing? Why our here I told you B is an array or B is a matrix, but why B is a column vector here? Because this was a single input single output system. What was the input here? It was only R of t. Suppose there were two inputs R1t and R2t, then your B would have been an array of appropriate dimension. Similarly, why our C matrix is a row vector? Because you had only one output. What is the output variable here? It is y of t. Okay. So in general, I can write this as like this, x dot equal to this thing. Okay. And what is my y output in matrix form is output. Okay. So before that, so this is x dot equals A x plus B U of t. This is what is the standard state space equation. Okay. And what will be the output? Output in matrix form. Output in matrix form is, so how many outputs do we have? We had Q outputs. Okay. So Y1, Y2, etc. up to YQ should be equal to what? So suppose C11, C12, etc. are the coefficients. So you will get C11, C12, etc. up to C1. What is it? What should it up to what C should go? C1n, because C into X it is. Okay. Did you get me what I'm saying? See, what is the output equation here? This was 1, 0 into X1, X2. Okay. So this is our C here. Okay. So there should be as many elements as the number of states here. Okay, so here why there are two elements in the C row vector? Because we have two state vectors. Okay, so the number of state vectors will give you that, will tell you the number of the entries in the C row of the C vector. Okay, so C1 and so let me complete this. This is X1, X2, blah, 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 Xn of t. Okay. So what is the next row? C21, C22, etc. up to C2. So it keeps on going like this, and you get C Q1, C Q2, etc. up to CQn. Okay. Plus what? Plus assume that D is the coefficient. Okay. D11, D12, etc. So I can write D11, D12, etc. up to D. Up to what order I should go? What is the number of inputs? P. So it should be D1P. Okay. D1P. Into what? U1, U2, etc. up to UP. Okay. So D21, D22, etc. up to D2. So moving on, it becomes D, DQ1. DQ2, etc. up to DQ. Okay, so this is my output vector Y. So X dot T, equal to, so this I will call as C, a matrix C into X of T plus D into U of T. Okay, so this is called standard state space representation. Okay, x dot equals ax plus bu. Y equals cx plus bu. Okay, so this ABCD matrices, they are called a state space form of representation. So what is this matrix A called? A is called system matrix. A is called system matrix. And since B is associated with the input vector, B is called input matrix. Input matrix. Okay. And matrix C is associated with the output basically. Okay. So C is called output matrix. And matrix D is called feed forward matrix. Why it is called feed forward? It will be clear. Just give me a moment. It will be clear. Okay, feed forward matrix. Okay. So these two equations together will make the state space model. Okay. This is the state space model. Okay. And one important point to be noticed that transfer function of a system is unique, but state space representation is not. What did I say? Transfer function is unique, but state space is not unique. That means for the same given plant, you can have only one transfer function, but there can be infinite number of state space models for the same given plant. Okay, transfer function is only one and only is one and is only one, one and one only. Transfer function will be there for a given plant, but there can be infinite number of state space models for a given system. Okay, we will prove that in due course of time. Okay. Now this thing can be represented in a pictorial form, that is called the state diagram. Okay, state diagram. Okay, in a block diagram, a pictorial representation, a pictorial representation of state equation and output equation. So this is called the output equation. Okay, what should I write? This is called output equation and this is called state equation. Together that is called state space model. Okay, a picture representation of state equation and output equation is called state diagram. And can be drawn from state model. Okay, so let us see how to draw them. So what is the state equation? X dot equals AX plus BU. And Y equals CX plus DU. Okay, so you have x dot and you have x. Okay, if you have x dot, how will you get x? You need to integrate that, correct? You need to integrate that. So here is an integrator. So to the integrator, signal going is x dot. So what is the output? It should be x of t. Integrator will integrate the derivative and give you the actual variable. Okay, now what is x dot? So if this is x dot, it is nothing but the sum of two terms, ax plus b. Okay, so there should be a summing point here. Okay, what's the first term? A into x. So that means there should be a channel at a gain of a coming from x. Okay, so if this signal is x, this signal is x. So this signal is ax. Okay, plus, right? Now what next? Plus b into u. So this is our input signal u, and it should pass through a gain of block b. So what will be the signal at this point? It will be b. So what is the output here? X dot equal to ax plus bu. Done. Okay. Now what is the output? C into x. So there should be a c block. Okay, and it should be added up. Okay. So the summing point here. So this signal will be c into x plus d into u. Okay, plus d. Let me wipe off this thing for a space. So write this here. Y equals cx plus bu. Okay, so cx we have. Then now what more we need? We need du. So from here I will take a path. It will go through a block of gain d, and that is given here. So this signal is d into u. So now you might be knowing why D is called a feed forward. It is feeding forward the control signal, the input signal U of T to the output summing point. That is why D is called feed forward transfer matrix. Okay, it is feeding forward the input signal to the output summing. So this is what is called the state space, just the state diagram. Okay, let us take one few examples now. Say you are given this network R, L, C. Okay, R, L, C plus minus. This is V of T. Okay, so let me take the inductor current. So you are asked to obtain the state space representation. How will you do? So the rule of thumb, right? Take the capacitor voltage and inductor current as the state variables. Okay. So let IL be the current and VC be the voltage. Okay, plus minus, right? So KVL, if you apply KVL, what will you get? So current will be flowing like this. So minus plus potential, right? So V of T must be equal to what? R into IL of T plus L into D IL by DT plus 1 by C integral IL dt. Okay. But you see, now we will define, let IL equals X1. Okay. Let IL of T equals X1 of T. And VC of T equals X2 of T. Fine. Now, so VC of T is this voltage. So I can write this as, this is one. So equation one implies what? V of T equals R IL of T plus L D IL of T by DT plus X2 of T. Okay, because what's X2? X2 is the voltage, X is the capacitance. And what is that? 1 by C integral I DT. So what is dl by dt here? So we need to bring the derivative term, the first order derivative term, to the left half of this, to the left hand side of the equality. Okay. So what will I get? Dl by dt will be equal to what? V of t by l minus r by l into il of t minus x2 by l. Okay, but IL is another state variable X1, so I can write this as what? X1 dot equal to what? V of T by L minus R by L into IL of T is X1 of T. X1 of T minus X2 of T divided by L. That is first equation, equation A. Okay, now what's the next equation? Capacitor voltage. Okay, so so what is capacitor current, or what could be the next equation? Tell me what could be the next equation. So VC is equal to what? 1 by C integral IL dt. Okay, that means 1 by C integral what is IL? X1 t dt. Okay, so what will be X1 t? Or what can I write? I can write like this. C into dVC by dt equal to what? Equal to IL of t. Okay. C dVC by dt equal to IL of t, correct? Because what is X1? X1 is IL, right? So I can write this as 1 by C integral X1 t dt. So C into dVC by dt will be equal to what? X1, which is nothing but IL. Okay. So what is dVC by dt? dVC by dt will be 1 by C into IL of t. And VC is X2. So what is dVC by dt? It is X2 dot t. Okay. So I can write the next equation as X2 dot t equal to what? 1 by C into IL of t. This is equation. Okay. So now what you have to do? You need to arrange it. Or this means 1 by C into X1 of t. Okay. So now in matrix form, X1 dot T, X2 dot T equals some matrix into what? X1 of T, X2 of T plus something into U of t. But here the U of t is V of t, the voltage applied. U of t is just the general notation for input signal. Here our U of t is nothing but the voltage V. Okay. Now what is x1 dot t? x1 dot t is minus R by L x1, then minus 1 by L x2 plus 1 by L V of t. And x2 dot is 1 by C x1. That means 1 by C x1. Okay. So equation is satisfied. And what is the output? Suppose output we are taking it across the capacity voltage. Okay. So output means nothing but V naught of t will be nothing but Vc of t. Okay. And what is Vc of t? Vc of t was defined as state variable x2. So that means x2. So what is my output by U of t will be 0, 1 into x1 of t, x2 of t plus d0, there's no u term, so that means 0 into v of t. Okay, so this way you can obtain the state space representation for the electrical network. Okay, now as I said before, state space representation is not unique. There can be infinite number of state space models for a same given system. Okay, now the same plant, it is more tied to model differently. Okay, again, let me draw the figure. R, L, C, and this is V. V of t, R, L, C. Okay. Now assume that you are taking the state space representation by considering capacitor voltage only as the state variable. Okay. Let me write the question here. Obtain the state space representation selecting capacitor voltage as state variable. Selecting capacitor voltage as state. Okay. So that means Vc of t is the state variable. Okay. So you see, let me define Vc of t is x1. Okay. So what will be Vc dot t? Vc dot t will be x1 dot t. That means x2 of t. Okay. Now you apply KVL here. What will you get? A current IL is flowing. Okay. So what will you get? V of t equals R into IL of t plus L into d IL of t by dt plus Vc of t. Plus Vc of t. Okay. Now what is IL from this? How will you relate IL and Vc? Capacitor current to the capacitance. Okay, so same current IL is flowing to the capacitance. So IL of t can be written as C into d Vc of t by dt. Is it not? Right? Vc equal to 1 by C integral Ic dt. So C into Vc will be what? Integral Ic dt. If you take the different derivative on both sides, you get C d Vc equal to Ic dt. Or what is your Ic? C into dVc by dt. That's what I have written here. Okay. So since it is in series, the same inductor current IL flowing through the inductors will be flowing through the capacitor too. Okay. So IL, I can write it as C into dVc by dt. Okay. So that means what is IL? Nothing but C into X2. C into X2 of t. Okay. C into X2 of t. So this can be written as, so I can write this as, x2 dot, how can I write this? So what will you get here? This becomes, so instead of IL, I will substitute this thing. So it becomes RC x2 of t. Okay. RC x2 of t plus L into this thing. So you will get LC. D by dt of this thing, that means x2 dot t. Okay, LC x2 dot t, right? See, how will you get this thing? See, L into the second term, okay, L into d IL by dt, that means L into d by dt of C into x2. So that means LC into X2 dot. Okay, so I can write this as LC into X2 dot T plus VC of T is nothing but X1 of T. So what will be X2 dot from this? X2 dot will be what? Will be V of T by LC minus R by L X2 minus 1 by LC into X1 of T. Okay, so what will be the state space representation? X1 dot X2 dot equals some matrix A into what? X1, X2 plus something else B into V of T. Okay, so what is X1 dot? X1 dot is X2, 0, 1, 0. What is X2 dot? Minus 1 by LC, then minus R by L, and 1 by LC. Okay, so if you measure the output across the voltage VC of T, Y of T will be what? Will be VC of T. That means nothing but X1 of T. So I can write this as X1 of T. So this becomes 1, 0 into X1 of T, X2 of T plus 0 into 0 into. So this is our A matrix. This is B, this is C, and this is D. So you can see here the A matrix in this case and A matrix in this case are different. Correct? That is why I said state space representation is not unique. Okay? Now, if you wish, you can obtain the state space representation selecting capacitor current as the state variable. Okay? Let us try that also. Same system. Okay? I didn't change. It is a series. RLC circuit. Okay? So, in the first case, we had the liberty to choose state variables. So, I chose inductor current IL and capacitor voltage VC as the state variable. In the second case, we were specifically asked to choose capacitor voltage as the state variable. So I have chosen VC, the voltage of the capacitor, as state variable. Now let us obtain the state variable, obtain the state space representation, obtain the state space representation by choosing inductor current as the state variable. Inductor current as the state variable. Okay, so what will you do? Same circuit. So R, L, C. V of T, R, L, C. Okay, so let IL be the current. Okay, so here when you choose IL as one of the state variables, okay, that's a question. Choosing inductor current as the state variable. So if you remember, I have told you about one point. What was that? Each differentiated variable can be chosen as a state variable. Okay, each differentiated variable can be chosen as a state variable. Right. So here you see what's the capacitor current. Capacitor current is IL. Okay, sorry. What's the inductor current? Inductor current is IL. Right. And inductor voltage is L di by dt. DIL by dt. Okay. So if I choose IL, let me choose IL. IL of t as X2. IL of t I will call as a state variable X2 of t. Okay, so this should be X1 dot, correct? If you remember, X1 dot equal to X2, X2 dot equal to X3, and so on. We define state variables in that order. Okay, so if I call IL of t as a state variable X2, okay, then this must correspond to X1 dot t. Okay, so what will be our X1 here? What could be our X1? X1 will be integral IL of t. Are you getting my point? X1 should be integral of IL of t. Okay, so now you see what you take X1 dot, what do you get X1 dot? X1 dot will be IL of t. IL of t, which is nothing but X2. So what will be X2 dot? X2 dot will be IL dot of t. And so on. Okay, so in this way, judiciously, you need to choose a state variable. See, state variables are the minimal set of variables. You cannot keep on taking redundant variables also. Okay, it should be always the minimal set of variables to describe the system. Got it? So in this way, I will define my state variable. Okay, so x1 is I integral IL of t, so that x1 dot is IL of t, which is nothing but x2, and x2 dot is IL dot, right? Now, if you apply KVL, what will you get? V of t equals R into IL of t plus L into d IL of t by dt plus 1 by C integral IL t dt. Okay, that means R into what is IL of t? X2 of t plus L into what is dIL by dt? It's nothing but x2 dot. Okay, dIL by dt means IL dot. Okay, so dIL by dt is x2 dot. So L x2 dot t plus 1 by C into integral IL of t is x1 of t. Okay, so that means what will be x2 dot? X2 dot t will be what? V of t by L minus R by L x2 of t minus 1 by L C x1 of t. And what is x1 dot? X1 dot is nothing but x2. Okay, so state model is complete. We are done with that. X1 dot x2 dot equals some matrix into x1 x2 plus some B matrix into U or V. Here V is the input signal. So what is x1 dot? X1 dot is x2. So that means 0, 1, 0. X1 dot is x2. What is x2 dot? V 1 by L into V of t, then minus 1 by L C and minus 1. Okay. If the output voltage is this thing, across voltage across the capacitance, so what will be V naught? V naught, output voltage V naught is what? Nothing but voltage across the capacitance. And what is the voltage across capacitance? It is nothing but IC into what? Integral ILT dt. That means IC into X1. Okay. So I can write my output equation Y as what? 1 by C 0 into X1 X2 plus 0 into V of T. Okay. So in this way, you can have infinite models for the same system. Right? You will see the mathematical proof very soon. Huh? Let me take up one more example. So up to now, we had taken up electrical system. Now we will take up a mechanical system. Assume we have a mechanical system like this. There's a damper, there's a spring connected to a mass, another damper, and another spring. This is mass M, this is B1, this is K1, B2, K, and this is the force applied, external applied force F of T. Okay. So what will be the force equation? You write in the first equation, applied force must be equal to what? Sum of the internal forces, right? So it will be equal to what? So if the, let the mean displacement be Y of T. Y of T, okay. F of T equals what? M into D square Y by DT square. Plus what? Plus B1 plus B2 into DY by DT plus K1 plus K2 into what? Into Y of T. Okay. Now what do? You define Y of T as X1. Let Y of T equal to X1. So what is Y dot T? X1 dot T. I call that as a new state variable X2 of T. Up to what point I have to go? I need to go up to Y double dot. Okay. And what is Y double dot T? Y double dot T is X2 dot T. That's enough. Okay. So what will be the equation? How can you write this? What is d square y by dt square? So this equation gives f of t equals m d square y by dt square. We have x2 dot m x2 dot t plus b1 plus b2 into dy by dt becomes x2 of t plus k1 plus k2 into y of t becomes x1 of t. Okay. So what will be x2 dot t? So from here you will get x2 dot t will be equal to what? F of t by m minus b1 plus b2 by m into x2 of t minus k1 plus k2 by m into x1 of t. Okay, so what's the state space representation now? Tell me. X1 dot x2 dot equal to A matrix into what? X1 x2 plus B matrix into u. And here the u is the input signal is the applied force f of t. What is x1 dot? X1 dot is x2, 0, 1, 0. What is x2 dot? F of t by m, so 1 by m. X1 is minus of k1 plus k2 by m. And x2 corresponding we have minus of b1 plus b2 by m. Okay, and if y of t is the output, what will you get? Y of t equal to x1 of t. That means 1, 0 into x1, x2 plus 0 into f of t. Okay, so this is the state space representation of this mechanical system. Okay, now let us take an armature control DC motor, an electromechanical system. Okay, so first we saw the electrical system. Now we took up a mechanical system. Now let us take an armature controlled DC motor, which is an electromechanical system. Armature controlled DC motor. Armature controlled DC motor. Okay. So what's the purpose of armature controlled DC motor? We know that industrial loads are mostly DC motor drives. Okay, DC motors are mostly used for industry purpose, right? So this armature control DC motor means you can adjust the armature voltage to control the motor. Okay, in a DC machine, there will be basically two windings. One is called the field winding and one is called the armature winding. Okay, how does a motor work? All electric machines operate on the principle of Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. What is Faraday's law? Whenever a time changing flux, magnetic flux links a coil, an EMF is induced. So to induce an EMF, you need a magnetic flux and within which a coil is time changing, a time changing effect between the coil and the flux. Okay, so here is armature winding. Armature winding has some resistance RA, some inductance LA. Okay, and since it's a motor, there will be a back EMF generator. Okay, and VA of T is the armature voltage, applied armature voltage plus minus. Okay, so here it will be EB. I can write back EMF EB of T plus minus. Okay, so this motor is connected to the mechanical load through a shaft. Okay, so the load is having a moment of inertia J, and B is the coefficient of viscous friction. Okay, so it has to supply the load torque TL. Okay, so this is the torque developed by the motor TM of T. Right, so this will be the angular displacement theta. Okay, and here is our field winding. Oh, I forgot to represent that. This is our field winding. It's a constant current flow. Okay, field winding. So if you apply KVL to this armature circuit, what will you get? KVL VA of T will be equal to RA into, so here a current IA will be flowing, so IA of T. So RA into IA of T plus LA into DIA of T by DT plus EB of T. Why plus EB of T? Because back EMF means it opposes the applied EMF. Okay, that is why as per the Lenz's law. Okay, the induced EMF will be in such a direction as to oppose the cause which produces the change in flux. Okay, so this is equation one. Okay, then what is back EMF? So this is armature voltage. Armature voltage. And what is back EMF? Back EMF is always proportional to the angular rotation, d theta by dt. Okay, so to introduce that proportionality, we introduce a constant kb into d theta by dt. That is back EMF. So our equation one becomes what? VA of T equals VA of T equals RA into IA of T plus LA into DIA of T by DT plus KB into D theta of T by a date. This is equation A. Okay. Now you see the torque developed by the motor, Tm of t. Okay. It should drive the moment of inertia of the rotating parts as well as the suspension and the load torque. Okay. That should be the motor torque developed. Okay. So motor torque or torque developed by the motor. Tm must be equal to what? J, that's the moment of inertia. So d square theta by dt square plus b d theta by dt plus the load torque TL of t. Okay, it should satisfy, it should supply both the moment of inertia, the viscous friction as well as the load torque. Okay, so this is the these many components need to be satisfied by the torque developed by the motor. Then only it can drive the load, right? It should overcome the friction, the inertia, all those things, right? And then it should drive the load torque. Okay, so this is three. And this motor torque, if you go through the theory of DC motor, you will see that it is proportional to the current. Okay, torque is proportional to current actually. Okay, so I can write this as say some constant KT into IA of t. This is equation four. Okay, so you see three must be equal to four. So that means KT into IA of t must be equal to what? J d square theta by dt square plus b d theta by dt or theta of t, huh? Plus t L of t. Okay, so what will be what how will we define the state variables here? Tell me. So here you see we have d theta by dt, and what else? What else do we have? We have IA of t also, right? IA of t, right? So you see the differentiated variable should be taken as the state variable. Okay. So we have what d IA by dt. So you can take IA as one of the state variables, and you can take theta of t as a theta of t or omega of t also. Both are correct. Okay. Both are correct, right? So let IA of t equal to x1. Okay. And omega of t. What is omega of t? Nothing but d theta by dt. I am calling that as x2. Okay. So from equation A, what will you get? Equation A, what will you get? VA of t equals RA into x1 of t plus LA into x1 dot t. Okay, because IA is x1 t, so IA dot will be x1 dot t. IA dot will be what? X1 dot t. So x1 dot t, okay, plus KB into omega, d theta by dt is omega, and omega I am calling it as x2 of t. So KB into x2 of t. Okay, then coming to this equation, this is five. Equation five implies what? KT into IA of t. IA of t is x1 of t equals what? J into, so it is d by dt of omega of t. That means x2 dot. So J x2 dot t plus B x2 t plus t L of t. T L of t. Okay. Now you need to arrange it in the standard form. So what is this? X1 dot t will be equal to what? VA of t by LA minus RA by LA into X1 of t minus KB by LA into X2 of t. And from here, what will you get? X2 dot t equal to what? X2 dot t will be equal to what? KT by J into X1 of t minus B by J into X2 of t minus TL of t by J. So in matrix form, what do you get? X1 dot X2 dot equal to what? Something into X1 X2 plus something into And here u is nothing but VA of t, the applied armature voltage. What is x1 dot? V of t by LA. So 1 by LA, then x1 is minus RA by LA, and x2 corresponds to minus KV by LA. Correct? Minus RA by LA, minus KV by LA. Right? So here, so load torque. So what are the inputs here? The inputs are the input. What are the input variables here? There are two input variables: one V of t and one TL of t. Okay. So it is not a V of t and TL of t will get, huh? So 1 by LA space 0. Then what is x2 dot? X2 dot will be KT by J, then minus B by J, minus TL by J, minus, did I make a mistake here? Minus 1 by J, correct, minus 1 by J. Okay, and if your omega is the output, if omega of T is the output, then what will you get? Y of T as, what was your omega? Omega was the, was your X2. So it will be 0, 1, X1 T, X2 T, plus 0 into U of T. Okay. So this way you can model an armature controlled DC motor. Okay. Now, so I think we will stop here for the day. Okay. And we'll meet again for a new lesson in the next class. Thank you.